Hey guys, Jonathan Selensky again with Distinguished Tactical. Before we get started on the stage, don't forget to like, follow, and subscribe on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. This stage, we started in position using a wobbly 4x4 for our support. We had to flip over chips, one chip at a time, that displayed a color. That color was the first target that we had to engage. Once we'd engaged that target, we flip over another chip, engage that target until all targets had been engaged or we time out. The catch for this stage was that all of the targets were snake trommers. If you're not familiar with a snake trommer target, it's essentially a little piece of pipe welded to all thread that's on a buoy in a water bucket. So when you hit the target, it moves around just like a snake in a basket. I chose to do a reverse kneeling for this stage because it offered me adequate support in both the front and the rear of the rifle for my position. As you can see, my position is relatively stable and the only misses were either due to wind or due to improper application of trigger fundamentals. I went into the stage with the intent to dial each target as they were revealed. After my second target though, I realized this is gonna take way too much time. I dial it to zero and I end up just doing holds for the rest of the stage. A drawback to these targets is if you clip them on the edge, they're gonna end up having a lot of movement and you're not gonna have time to wait for them to stop moving completely before engaging them with the second shot. As you saw on the last blue target, I engaged it with my second shot while it was in the move. I waited for it to reach its apex and fired then. I didn't fire at where it was, I fired at where it was going to stop and turn around because that was where it was going to be stationary. As you can see, switching to holds drastically decreased my time in between each target, and I was able to engage my last three targets much quicker than my first three. But because I dialed the first couple, I still didn't have quite enough time left and I end up timing out with my first shot on the final target. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Have a good one.